Listen, what are the objectives of this video lesson? On completion of this period, you would be able to know properties of plastics, advantages of plastics, limitations of plastics, polyvinyl chloride, polyethylene, bakelite. Okay, after completion of this video lesson, you would be able to know properties of plastics, advantages of plastics, limitations of plastics, next preparation and uses of polyvinyl chloride, next preparation and uses of polyethylene, next preparation and uses of bakelite. And also we discuss about polystyrene, urea formaldehyde, Teflon. The properties of plastics already we have discussed in the last video lesson. Just we revise. Plastics are light in weight, resistant to corrosion and insects, low cost of fabrication, good thermal and electrical insulation, high tensile strength. Okay, light in weight, resistant to corrosion and insects, low cost of fabrication, good thermal and electrical insulation, high tensile strength. Okay, next we discuss about another properties of plastics. Plastics have high refractive index. Plastics have low thermal expansion coefficient. Ease in molding to complicated shapes. Decorative surface effect. Impermeable to water. Okay, plastics have also high refractive index, low thermal expansion coefficient. Ease in molding to complicated shapes, decorative surface effect, impermeable to water. Okay, next we discuss about advantages of plastics over traditional materials. Advantages of plastics over traditional materials. Okay, ease of transportation and installation compared to the traditional materials. Okay, transportation is easy. Next, installation is also easy. No corrosion unlike metals. That means metals undergo corrosion, but plastics are highly corrosion resistant due to chemical inertness. Okay, metals undergo corrosion, metal articles undergo corrosion, but plastic articles are highly corrosion resistant due to chemical inertness. Okay, plastics inert to water, oils, acids and alkali. That means plastics do not react with water, oils, acids and alkali. Okay, take a variety of colors do not fade easily. Take a variety of colors do not fade easily. That means they have the ability to take variety of colors and shades and they do not fade easily. Okay, plastics have the ability to take variety of colors and shades and they do not fade easily. Okay, next, plastics are non-biodegradable. Plastics are non-biodegradable. Low cost of fabrication. That means low cost of fabrication. That means the price of plastic articles is less than that of articles made by metals. The price of plastic articles is less than that of articles made by metal. Okay, next, flexible and tough. Example, unbreakable plastics. Flexible and tough. Example, unbreakable plastics. Next, cutting, drilling and molding is possible. Cutting, drilling and molding is possible on plastics. It means cutting and drilling of plastics are easy when compared to those of wood and metal. Cutting and drilling of plastics are easy when compared to those of wood and metal. Okay, next, Plastics are easy to maintain unlike metal and wood. Plastics have shining and glossy surfaces. Next, they have a good dimensional stability. They have good shock absorption capacity. These are the advantages of plastics collision. Advantages of plastics over traditional materials. The price of plastics articles is less than that of articles made by metal. Plastics are not affected by insects, fungi, whereas wooden articles are damaged by them. Metal articles undergo corrosion, but plastics are highly corrosion resistant due to chemical inertness. Plastics are easy to maintain unlike metal and wood. Plastics have shining and glossy surfaces. Cutting and drilling of plastics are easy when compared to those of wood and metal. They have good shock absorption capacity. They have a good dimensional stability. They have the ability to take variety of colors and shades, and they do not fade easily. Next, flexible and tough. Example, unbreakable plastics. These are the advantages of plastics over traditional materials. Okay, next we discuss about disadvantages of plastics. Okay, cost. Some plastics costlier than some traditional materials. Plastics are costlier than some traditional material. Easily combustible. That means if we heat the plastics, they burn easily. Next, plastics have poor ductility. Plastics have poor ductility. That means very soft. Next, deform due to rise of pressure. Deform due to rise of pressure. That means pressure is applied on plastics. Plastic shape is changed. Next, low heat resistance. Suppose heat is increased, plastics can be soft. Next, non-biodegradable and cause pollution. Plastics are non-biodegradable and cause pollution. These are the disadvantages of plastics collision. Plastics costlier than some traditional materials. Plastics easily combustible. Their plastics have poor ductility. Deform due to rise of pressure. Low heat resistance. Non-biodegradable and cause pollution. Okay, observe diagrams one by one. These are the PVC, polyvinyl chloride plastics or electrical conduits. Okay, next this is the polyethylene wire cable. That means this wire cable is prepared by polyethylene plastic. And this is the plastic bag. This is prepared by polyethylene. And these are the switches. These are prepared by Bakelite. Okay. All articles I have shown, some plastic articles. All these articles are prepared by plastics. Now we discuss preparation and uses of some plastics. Okay, now we discuss preparation and uses of some plastics. First we discuss polyethylene. First, we take monomer, that is ethylene. Ethylene formula is CH2 double bond CH2. What is the ethylene means? CH2 double bond CH2. Heating ethylene to 250 degrees centigrade at 1000 to 200 atmospheres pressure in presence of oxygen gives polyethylene. Listen, heating the ethylene to 250 degrees centigrade at 1000 to 2000 atmospheres pressure in presence of oxygen catalyst, this ethylene gives polyethylene. In these conditions, ethylene units are added to themselves to give addition polymer. Okay, this polyethylene is the addition polymer. So this polyethylene is prepared by the addition polymerization of ethylene at 250 degrees centigrade and 2000 to 2000 atmosphere pressure in presence of oxygen catalyst. Okay, listen. Ethylene is a monomer. Ethylene formula CH2 double bond CH2. Okay. Polyethylene is prepared by the addition polymerization of ethylene at 250 degree centigrade and 1000 to 2000 atmosphere pressure in presence of oxygen catalyst. Okay, this is about the preparation of ethylene. Okay, this is the reaction of preparation of polyethylene. Okay, this is the polyethylene. In this polyethylene, more number of ethylene units present. Okay, already I have explained. This polyethylene is prepared by the addition polymerization of ethylene at 250 degree centigrade and 1000 to 2000 atmosphere pressure in presence of oxygen catalyst. Okay, CH2 double bond CH2. Here, n number of ethylene monomers present. These ethylene monomers attached one by one like chain, then polyethylene is prepared. This is one ethylene unit, this is another ethylene unit, this is another ethylene unit. One unit form the bond, another unit, another unit. More number of ethylene units present in the polyethylene. Okay, depending on the number of units joined, two grades of polyethylene. One is LD polyethylene, that means lower number of units present. HD polyethylene, that means high number of units are prepared. This is the reaction of preparation of polyethylene. Listen, how the bond is formed. We take CH2 H2C double bond CH2. First we take two units. How the bond is formed between these two units. This is the H2C double bond CH2. These are the ethylene monomers, double bond present between the carbons. When this bond is broken, here one carbon electron present, here one electron present. Here also bond is broken, then here one electron present. Here one electron present. This electron forms a bond with this electron of carbon. Then bond is formed between these two carbons. Next again this carbon form one another unit of ethylene. Then here also another bond is formed. All units are combined together like this. Okay, this is about the preparation of polyethylene. Okay, next we discuss about uses of polyethylene. It is used as preparation of flexible bottles. Next, blood bags. Next, it is used as preparation of ties. It is used as sheets for packing. It is used as preparation of cable and cable conduits. Next, it is used as in the preparation of kitchen and domestic appliances. It is used as in the preparation of high frequency insulators. These are the uses of polyethylene. It is used in the preparation of flexible bodies, blood bags, ties, sheets for packing, cable and cable conduits, kitchen and domestic appliances, high frequency insulators. These are the uses of polyethylene. Okay, listen, these water bottles are plastic water bottles. These are prepared by the polyethylene. Okay, next we discussed about the preparation of uses of bakelite. This is the Bakelite plastic. This switchboard is prepared by the Bakelite plastic. How it is prepared means, in the preparation of Bakelite, phenol and formaldehyde are used. These two are monomers. Phenol formula is C6H5OH. Formaldehyde formula HCHO. These two, phenol and formaldehyde, undergo condensation polymerization to give first ortho and para methylol phenol. Next, in presence of acid or alkali, can be used as catalyst. Okay. Already I have told, this is the phenol structure, this is the formaldehyde. These two are monomers. These two are react in presence of acidic media and form ortho and para hydroxyl methyl benzene. Ortho and para hydroxyl methylo benzene. These are the ortho hydroxy methyl benzene. This is the para hydroxy methylol benzene. This is the functional group. Another functional group is present in the this carbon, that is ortho position, this is the meta position, this is the para position. So this group is present on the ortho position. So this is ortho hydroxyl methylo benzene. Here this group is present on para position. So this is para hydroxyl methylo benzene. Okay, first ortho and para hydroxyl methylo benzenes are formed by the reaction of phenol and formaldehyde in presence of acidic media. Okay, in the second step, ortho and para hydroxy methylol benzenes lose H2O molecules and form novaloc. This is the novaloc. Okay, these two are ortho hydroxy methylol benzene. It lost these two units of ortho hydroxy methyl benzene. These two units loss H2O molecules and combine and form novaloc. Novaloc is formed. Third step, novaloc on heating with hexamine, hexamethylene tetramine, that means forms Bakelite. Okay, in the second step, novaloc is formed. That novaloc on heating with hexamine, then it gives forms Bakelite. Novaloc on heating with hexamine forms Bakelite. This is the Bakelite section. That means more number of methylol benzenes condensed and lost H2O molecules and form this type of cross-linked structure. This is the Bakelite. This is the structure of Bakelite. This is the preparation of Bakelite. Okay, listen. First we take phenol and formaldehyde. These two react in presence of acidic media and form ortho and para hydroxyl methylol benzenes. These ortho and para hydroxyl methylol benzenes participate in condensation polymerization and form novaloc. Novaloc on heating with hexamine form Bakelite. This is the preparation of Bakelite. Okay, take flow chart. Flow diagram of Bakelite preparation, phenol and formaldehyde react in presence of acidic media, ortho and para hydroxyl methylo benzenes are formed. These lose H2O molecules and form novaloc. On heating with hexamine form Bakelite. This is the flow chart of Bakelite preparation. Next we discuss about uses of Bakelite. Bakelite is used binder for grinding wheels, cabinets of telephones, radio, television, cabinets of telephones, radio, television, computer. Next, electrical insulating parts like switch plugs, switchboards, heater handles. Next, ion exchangers, adhesives. Next, paints and varnishes. Okay, what are the uses of Bakelites means? These are used in binder for grinding wheels. These are used in the preparation of binder for grinding wheels. These are used, Bakelite is used in the preparation of cabinets of telephones, radio, television, computer. Next, Bakelite is used in the preparation of electrical insulating parts like switch plugs, switchboards, heater handles. All plastic plugs, switches, heater handles are Bakelite plastics. Next, Bakelite is used in the preparation of ion exchangers, adhesives. Bakelite is also used in the paints and varnishes. These are the uses of Bakelite. Okay, next we discuss about another plastic, that is polyvinyl chloride. It is simply stated as PVC, PVC, polyvinyl chloride, PVC. We are also Lisa PVC term. Okay, first, in this preparation vinyl chloride is taken. That vinyl chloride is monomer. Vinyl chloride formula is CH2 double bond CHCl. That means, what is the formula of ethylene? CH2 double bond CH2. In that ethylene, one chlorine is present in the place of hydrogen. That is the vinyl chloride. Vinyl chloride formula is CH2 double bond CHCl. Next, addition polymerization of vinyl chloride in presence of benzoyl peroxide or hydrogen peroxide catalyst under pressure, PVC is prepared. Okay, polyvinyl chloride is prepared by the addition polymerization of vinyl chloride in presence of benzoyl peroxide or hydrogen peroxide catalyst under pressure. Okay, this is the polyvinyl chloride formula. In this polyvinyl chloride also contain more number of vinyl chloride units. More number of vinyl chloride units. Okay, how the bond is formed between the two vinyl chloride units? Take, this is the H2. Double bond CH Cl. Let's take another unit H2 C double bond CH Cl. A double bond is broken, then this carbons will get one electron. Here also double bond is broken, this carbons will get one electron. This unpaired electron of carbon forms bond with this unpaired electron of carbon, then bond is formed between these two units. Next, this carbon is formed another vinyl chloride. This carbon is formed bond with another vinyl chloride unit. So here, like this, more number of vinyl chloride units combined together, then polyvinyl chloride is formed. Polyvinyl chloride is formed. Okay. Polyvinyl chloride is prepared by the addition polymerization of vinyl chloride in presence of benzoyl peroxide or hydrogen peroxide catalyst under pressure. Next, we discuss the uses of PVC or polyvinyl chloride. It is used in the preparation of polyvinyl chloride is a brittle plastic. Brittle plastic. It can be made soft by mixing with plasticizers. So PVC is two grades, rigid and plasticized. PVC is of two grades, rigid and plasticized. What are the characteristics of polyvinyl chloride? Polyvinyl chloride is a brittle plastic. It can be made soft by mixing with plasticizers. So PVC is of two grades, rigid and plasticized. Okay, next we discuss about uses of polyvinyl chloride. It is used in the preparation of safety helmets, light fittings, trays, refrigerator components. Okay, next it is used in the preparation of packing and raincoats, tablecloth, shoe soles, PVC foam as insulator lining. These are the uses of polyvinyl chloride. Okay, PVC is used in the preparation of safety helmets, light fittings, trays, refrigerator components. Next, it is used in the preparation of packing. Next, raincoats, tablecloth, shoe soles, PVC foam, and insulator linings. These are the uses of polyvinyl chloride. This is the safety helmet. It is prepared by the polyvinyl chloride. Generally, we use safety helmets by riding the vehicles. Okay, next we discuss about another plastic, that is polystyrene. Okay, how the polystyrene is prepared means, in this preparation, styrene is taken. Styrene is a monomer. Styrene is a monomer. What is the formula of styrene means? C6H5, CH double bond CH2. We observe, you take ethylene CH2 double bond CH2. You place the benzene ring in the place of one hydrogen in the ethylene. That is the styrene. Okay, this is the CH2. CH2 is the ethylene. You write benzene ring in the place of one hydrogen in the ethylene. That is the styrene. Styrene formula C6H5 CH double bond CH2. Styrene is dissolved in a solvent. Benzoyl peroxide catalyst is added. Heating the mixture produces polystyrene by addition polymerization. Okay, listen. Polystyrene is prepared by the addition polymerization of styrene in presence of benzoyl peroxide catalyst and heating. This is the preparation of polystyrene. And this is the reaction of preparation of polystyrene. This is the polystyrene formula. That means benzene ring CH bond CH of N. This is the poly. This is the styrene. More number of styrene units are participated in addition polymerization in presence of benzoyl peroxide. After that, you heat, this styrene molecules are converted to polystyrene. This is the preparation of polystyrene. A thermocol is the example of polystyrene. This is the polystyrene foam. Okay, next we discuss about the uses of polystyrene. Okay, it is used in the preparation of insulator for high frequency current cables. Making of toys, polystyrene is used in the making of toys, combs, radio and TV parts. Already you know that toys, combs, radio and TV parts. It is used in the making of battery cases. Battery cases is also prepared by the plastic. That plastic is the polystyrene plastic. Making foams for shock proof packaging. Okay, next. Polystyrene is used in the making scratch proof glasses. It is also used in the making heels of footwear. These are the uses of polystyrene. Then it is used in the preparation of insulator for high frequency current cables. It is used in the making of toys, combs, radio and TV parts. It is used in the making of battery cases. It is used in the making foams for shock-proof packaging. Generally, suppose if we buy the fridge that is packed in the one cotton box, that cotton box contains thermocol, that fridge is placed in the thermocol, then that thermocol protected the fridge by shocks. So this thermocol is polystyrene. It is used in the making scratch food glasses. It is used making heels of footwear. Okay, next we discuss about the preparation of urea formaldehyde. This is another plastic. Okay, first we discuss preparation of urea formaldehyde. In this preparation, we take urea and formaldehyde. This urea and formaldehyde are monomers. Urea and formaldehyde are monomers. These two are taken in 2:1 ratio. That means 2 units of urea is participated, 1 unit of formaldehyde participated. Next, hexamethylene tetramine is catalyst, heated to 50 degree centigrade. Reaction produces methylol urea. Condensation polymerization produces urea formaldehyde resin. Urea formaldehyde resin. This is the preparation of urea formaldehyde. So, urea formaldehyde is prepared by the condensation polymerization of urea and formaldehyde at 50 degree centigrade in presence of hexamethylene tetramine catalyst. Tetramine catalyst. Okay, now we discuss. This is the urea H2NCONH2 formaldehyde formula. Already you know that HCHO. 2 units of urea and 1 unit of HCHO is participated. That means urea and formaldehyde is participated in 2:1 ratio at 50 degree centigrade in presence of hexamethylene tetramine catalyst. First, dimethylol urea is formed. This is the dimethylol urea is formed. In this preparation, H2O is lost. H2O is lost. Okay, then all more number of units combine together and form urea formaldehyde polymer. Urea formaldehyde polymer collision. Urea and formaldehyde are participated in 2:1 ratio at 50 degree centigrade in presence of hexamethylene tetramine catalyst. These two form first dimethylol urea. This dimethylol urea condensed, that means H2O is lost. Then urea and formaldehyde polymer is formed. This is the preparation of urea formaldehyde plastic or resin. Okay, you observe here. This is the urea unit. This is also urea unit. This is the formaldehyde unit. Already I have told urea and formaldehyde are participated in 2:1 ratio. These two units, this is 1 unit, 2:1 ratio. At 50 degree centigrade in presence of hexamethylene tetramine catalyst, these two units and formaldehyde react and loss H2O molecule like this. Like this. Okay, listen. This urea molecule of hydrogen, this urea molecule of hydrogen and formaldehyde oxygen combine and form H2O, that H2O is lost in this reaction. Then, collision. Okay. Already, this is urea 1 unit. This is another unit of urea. It means 2 units of urea are participated. 1 unit of formaldehyde is participated. This, when formaldehyde and urea participated in reaction, H2O molecule is eliminated like this. One hydrogen of this urea unit, another hydrogen of this unit and formaldehyde oxygen, here oxygen, these combine and these are eliminated like H2O. Then this carbon forms bond with this nitrogen, and also this carbon forms bond with this nitrogen, then urea formaldehyde is formed. This is the reaction. Okay, these are the plastic plates already we know. These are prepared by the urea formaldehyde plastics. This is the decorative article. This is prepared by the urea formaldehyde plastic. Okay. Next, we discuss uses of urea formaldehyde plastic. The thermosetting plastic used in molding of decorative articles, glasses, dinnerware, dishes, buttons. Okay. Urea formaldehyde is a thermosetting plastic. This thermosetting plastic used in molding of decorative articles, glasses, dinnerware, dishes, buttons. Next, urea formaldehyde is used in the preparation of bottle caps. It is used as adhesive. Next, bonding plywood like is used as a fabrical. It is used as in the preparation of electrical insulations. Next, it is used in the preparation of cation exchangers. These are the uses of urea formaldehyde. Okay, listen. Urea formaldehyde is a thermosetting plastic. This thermosetting plastic used in molding of decorative articles, glasses, dinnerware, dishes, buttons. It is used in the preparation of bottle caps. It is used as adhesives. It is used like bonding plywood. It is used in the preparation of electrical insulators. It is used in the preparation of cation exchangers. Okay, next we discuss about the preparation of polytetrafluoroethylene. It is also named as Teflon. Okay, polytetrafluoroethylene is called Teflon. Polytetrafluoroethylene, okay, in this preparation we take tetrafluoroethylene. This tetrafluoroethylene is monomer. Tetrafluoroethylene formula is CF2 double bond CF2. That means we take ethylene CH2 double bond CH2. In the ethylene, we take 4 fluorine atoms in the place of 4 hydrogen atoms. Means CF2 double bond CF2 tetrafluoroethylene. This tetrafluoroethylene undergoes addition polymerization, high pressure or benzoyl peroxide catalyst can be employed. Okay. Teflon is prepared by the addition polymerization of tetrafluoroethylene at high pressure in presence of benzoyl peroxide catalyst. Okay, listen. Teflon or polytetrafluoride is prepared by the addition polymerization of tetrafluoroethylene at high pressure in presence of benzoyl peroxide catalyst. Okay, this is the reaction, preparation reaction of Teflon. Okay, this is the tetrafluoroethylene. We take more number of units. Here double bond is broken. These carbons will get one electron. This carbon form another unit of tetrafluoroethylene. This carbon forms bond another unit of tetrafluoroethylene. So all tetrafluoroethylene molecules combine together by addition polymerization and form polytetrafluoroethylene. This is the Teflon. This is the reaction. Next, uses of Teflon. It is used in the preparation of wires and cable insulations. It is used in the preparation of wires and cable insulation. It is used in the preparation of non-sticking cookware. Already we know that non-stick cookware. Stopcocks of burettes. Burette stopcocks are prepared by Teflon. Next, it is used in the preparation of gaskets. Gaskets means this is the sealing pads. Next, packing, tank linings, chemical carrying pipes. It is used in the preparation of gaskets, packing, tank linings, chemical carrying pipes. It is used in the magnetic bed covering. It is used in the preparation of coating, impregnating optical gauze fibers, cloths. These are the uses of Teflon. Listen. Teflon is used in the preparation of wires and cable insulations. Teflon is used in the preparation of non-stick cookware, stopcocks of burettes. Next, it is used in the preparation of gaskets, packing, tank linings, chemical carrying pipes. Next, Teflon is used in the magnetic bed covering. Next, Teflon is used in the coating and impregnating optical glass fibers cloths. Okay, this is the Teflon plastic. This is the Teflon plastic. Let's summarize the lesson. Density, resistance to heat, corrosion properties. Okay, density, resistant to heat, corrosion, impermeability, inertness, high glossy, low cost, strength are some unique properties of plastics. Unique properties of plastics keep them ahead of traditional materials. Next, non-biodegradability, deformation due to pressure and temperature, combustibility are certain disadvantages. Next, polyethylene is made by addition polymerization of ethylene. Two grades, LDPE and HDPE, depending on degree of polymerization. Bakelite is made by condensation polymerization of phenol and formaldehyde. Next, PVC is made by addition polymerization of vinyl chloride. Polyethylene is used for making flexible appliances, toys, wires and cables. Bakelite is used for making electrical switches, plugs and switchboards, cabinets. Next, PVC is used for safety elements, refrigerator components, packing and foams. Next, polystyrene is prepared by addition polymerization of styrene with benzoyl peroxide as catalyst. Polystyrene used as insulator for high frequency current and shock proof foams. Next, Teflon is prepared by polymerization of tetrafluoroethylene using benzoyl peroxide as catalyst. Next, urea formaldehyde is prepared by condensation polymerization of urea and formaldehyde used in molding preparation of adhesives. Okay, we discuss some multiple choice questions. First question, plastics are used to make electrical switches because of A, low cost, B, electrical resistance, C, high strength, D, attractive. Already you know that plastics are electrical resistance. So B is the correct answer. So plastics are electrical resistance. That's why plastics are used to make electrical switches. Plastics are used to make electrical switches because of electrical resistance. Okay, next question. Pipes for water transportation are made of polystyrene, bakelite, polyethylene, rubber. Polystyrene or PVC. C is the correct answer. Okay, unbreakable plastic is bakelite, melamine, formaldehyde, nylon, PVC. Unbreakable plastic is PVC, polyvinyl chloride. So D is the correct answer. D is the correct answer. Okay, another one. Great disadvantages of plastic is deformation, combustibility, hardness, non-biodegradability. Okay, great disadvantages of plastic is non-biodegradability. It causes pollution of environment. So D is the correct answer. D is the correct answer. Okay, next another question. Phenol and formaldehyde on polymerization form a plastic known as polyvinyl chloride, polyvinyl cyanide, urea formaldehyde resin, bakelite. Already we have discussed. That is bakelite. D is the correct answer. Phenol and formaldehyde on polymerization form a plastic known as bakelite. Bakelite is the correct answer. D is the correct answer. Okay, what we have discussed in the video lesson? Some questions are asked frequently in the examination. Those questions are Students, state the characteristics properties of plastics. State the advantages of plastics over traditional materials. List the disadvantages of plastics. Okay, some more questions are also asked in the examination. Name the monomers used for the preparation of polyethylene, bakelite and PVC. How polyethylene is prepared, mention its uses. How bakelite is prepared, mention its uses. How PVC is prepared, mention its uses. What is novaloc? How it can be converted to bakelite? Next, distinguish between rigid PVC and flexible PVC. Okay, thank you for the listening of this video lesson.